Alright, we're rolling.
I want to thank everybody for coming on tonight. We're going to try to get everybody to the opportunity to introduce themselves to the voting public, as large a crowd as we have here. So the format, Benny's one of our firemen, and he's going to be our moderator tonight, make sure everything goes smoothly. Each candidate is drawn straws, and they will be done in order. Each one will get 2 minutes to state their qualifications or anything else they want to talk about as far as the village goes. One question will come out of that bag for each candidate, and then they get 2 minutes to wrap up. So we'll have everybody out of here hopefully by 7:30. So I know Walt wants to see the baseball game. It's going to be a good one too, right?
Yeah. So.
All right, with that.
All right, well, I'll do my level best to make sure we can kind of keep it moving. First of all, welcome to Meet the Candidate tonight. I'm about to remind you, though. My name is Benny Jones, like the mayor mentioned. I've been here, been a resident here for around about 30 years. I think I moved when I was 10, I'm 40 now. So why? And I've worked at the Village Fire Department for 16 years. And the village has been good to me, so when they ask me to do something, the answer is never no. I always say yes. I love it here. We have, as you all would know, I'm sure, we have 4 open council seats on the ballot for Election Day, November 7th, Tuesday. 5 candidates running for council are Tom DiCarlo, Vaughn Hoffman, Vicky Jeromos, but Dan Blaney, she's not here, and who else do we have here? I'm sorry. Mark Kondik and Becky Kolach. Just in an effort to be fair, we should probably, well, I'll say that, Vicky Jeromos Blaney, she's not going to be here on time, and it's, as I understand it, they have a school board meeting, and I should know this because my little girl's there singing a song at the school board meeting, but her daughter received an award, so she didn't want to miss that, so she may be running a bit late, so in an effort to be fair to her, we're going to allow her to come here, and she'll get involved when she gets here, but it wasn't something that was frivolous that was going to cause her to be late. She just is going to be late this evening, so. What we'll do here is we'll start with each candidate giving 2 minutes. They'll have a 2-minute opening statement, and they will answer one couple of questions, like she mentioned, and give a final statement. And what happened just seconds ago, or minutes ago, rather, is they drew straws. So we're going to start with Vicky Jeromos Blaney. Obviously, she's not here, so that didn't work out well for her, but she'll join us when she gets here. And so we'll start with Tom DiCarlo.
Thanks, Benny. My name's Tom DiCarlo, as you can see here. I've lived in the village for 26 years, not all consecutively. I moved here with my parents when I was 8, similar to Benny there. I currently live in Harrington Place, and I still also own a condo in Aurora Shores for 18 years now. I graduated from the University of Akron with a corporate finance degree. That only took me like 30 years, but I did it. I was elected to be one of the commissioners for the Charter Commission when Reminderville decided that they thought we wanted to be a charter community, along with Mark. I've also been on the JED board for approximately 9 years, even before I was on council. I have served a few of those years as the chairperson of the JED that rotates between a village board member and a township board member. The past 2 years of the JED, I have been secretary and treasurer. Past 8 years, I have been a member of the finance committee. I don't know exactly, but most of those, I have been a chairperson of that as well. This is going to be the end of my second term on council. And it all started with giving a call to the mayor. I wanted to be part of the Vision 2020 committee. And so with Lee Bartleman, kind of got us all started. I know, same with Mark, too. And that's how I began being part of the village. So I hope you vote for me come Tuesday. Thank you.
All right. Our time will be followed by Walt Altman.
Hello. I think the audience is small, and everyone here probably knows me, so I'm going to change what I was going to say just a little bit, except, of course, for Grandma and Kyle. lived here all my life. This is where my family was raised. And it's been a wonderful place to grow and see your family grow up. And because of that, and as time went on, I became more and more committed to this community. I've served in many capacities. I've been enjoying the activities that go on and supervise those. I served on various committees like Tom, whether it be Finance Committee or Recreation Committee. I was at the JED from the first meeting on, and I've served the entire almost 20 years now on that JED. And let me say what an important committee that is, and I think everyone in this room knows that because of the revenue that it generates for us. So the commitment that I have for this community is because of the joy this community has given me. 4 years ago, when I got the chance to serve on council and I was appointed to fill a vacancy, I think my eyes were even more opened because you saw everything that's going on, just individual little things here and there. And you realize just how important it is to have commitment, and that is what I bring to this table. I am committed to Reminderville, and I can promise you that I will do everything in my power if elected. I'm going to continue to serve whether I'm elected or not because there's too many things going on, so I'll do something. But it still comes down to I am committed to everything I can do to make this community the best it can be. Thank you.
Mr. Alden will be followed by Becky Kovach.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming out tonight. My name is Becky Kovach. I was appointed to council in July of 2017. A little bit about myself. After my husband Kyle and I moved here, he started grad school, so I decided to try to stay busy. I started working part-time at the Reminderville Athletic Club, volunteering for events, and then I joined the Finance Committee and started attending council meetings. Professionally, I have worked in local government since 2005. I'm the mayor's assistant for the city of North Olmsted. I've been a public servant my entire life, and I honestly have a passion for it, otherwise I wouldn't be here. I bring a lot to the table. I'm an active board member in the Cuyahoga County Mayor's Secretaries Association. I've met so many great people. There's professionals there who have worked for a municipality for 30 years. It's a great organization, great networking tool, learned a lot. Recently, I recommended that council join the Northeast Ohio City Council Association. Being a small village, I think it's important that we collaborate with other cities, and I know we do that now, but this is a group of 80 municipalities. I think it's important to see what else is out there. We don't want to miss anything. We have to make the best decisions for Reminderville, and that's exactly what I plan to do, so I hope you give me that opportunity, and I hope to speak with all of you that I don't know too much at the end of this. Thank you.
All right, Becky will be followed by Mark Condit.
Hi, my name is Mark Condit, and I've lived at the corner of Glenwood and Illinois for 13 years with my wife and two daughters. I've been your councilman for 8 years. And I'm assuming since you had enough interest to be here tonight, you've had an opportunity to see my list of committees and liaison to the seniors and JED board, so I won't recite that. I'll be happy to talk about it again during the one-on-one, but what I really want to get across is why I want to run again, because I say after 8 years, I still feel there's unfinished business. We need to continue working on the roads and the water drainage for sure, but I'm concerned about the rec center. We've got a year under our belt, and we've had trouble putting stable leadership in place. Our first year we had a program director, but we had trouble stabilizing the RAC director position. Now with Aaron in at the RAC supervisor position, I'm hoping that he's the right man for the job and he'll be there a long time, but now we don't have a program director. We need to establish the roles of these people to ensure the stability of the rec center, which I feel is very important to the future of Reminderville. I mean, for instance, if anybody was at the Halloween party Saturday, Aaron was running it, and I don't think that's what we hired him for, to throw kids' parties. I think we hired him to run an effective rec center. I think we need to put another program director in place, and we need strong leadership in both positions. I think we were a little hasty to disband the Parks and Rec Committee. I'm glad Laura's here, because when Colleen was here, she came to us for advice, and we told her what we did to make the Halloween party to make the Easter egg party work. Aaron just started, and God bless him, he did the best he could. But I think the Parks and Rec people, if we put that back together, can help the new program director.
All right, thank you, Mark. All right, now for the question portion, we have 5 questions. They're numbered in the bag. Each candidate will pull a question, and then we'll go in order. The number that's marked on the question that they pulled. The questions are from the audience, and there were some other questions that we provided as well in the event that not enough people had, you know, interested parties had questions. So what we'll do is we'll pass the bag down, allow you guys to pick them. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, this is a great question. So there are quite a few rental properties throughout the village. Would you support a landlord registration policy and a rental housing inspection program? Okay, so this is a great question because I actually, when I started working for a municipality, it was in Garfield Heights, where I grew up, and I started working in the building department. So we did rental registrations and point of sale inspections. I think it is important because it's important to know who's living there or how many people and things like that, making sure all the ordinances are being followed. But as far as inspections, it's important, I mean, as you know, as far as fire and electrical and all that, you want to make sure that's all up to code. And it also keeps our housing values, it keeps our housing values up. I mean, I know a lot of people say, oh, renters don't care, you know, they don't maintain their property. But when you have a rental inspection in effect, you have that ability to make citations and make sure that the properties are up to value. So I absolutely would support a landlord registration and a housing inspection program. That's a great question.
Thank you. Number 3.
I was number
3. All right, Mr. Alvin, go ahead. Read your line.
Well, I've already hinted at this, that you're going to think I have some kind of visionary spirit. Because the question is, if you're not elected, what would you do to try to help work on ideas or issues that are important to you? Like I've said before, I'm really committed, and wherever I'm called, someone asked me once, in fact, it was before the last election with levy campaign, about, oh, will you ever say no? And I said, there's two organizations that I will not say no to, the library and the school district. And now I'm going to tell you there's 3 that I'll never say no to, the library, the school district, or this village. How will I help? Well, some of them, if you're not elected, you have less of a chance to do it. For instance, I'm concerned about the whole idea of being fiscally responsible, because we're on a borderline here. We get so much revenue, and we have to make commitments that everybody wants. Everyone wants a good police department. Everyone wants a good fire department. Everyone wants a good emergency squad to come in here. We want to keep our amenities. We want to make the RAC so that it's financially stable and it's supporting itself. Those are the kinds of things that you lose that opportunity when you're not, I think, here, except coming to meeting and voicing your opinions. But anything else that goes on, and that means community events, when there's Halloween parties, if that recreation committee went and got back into vogue here to help with things, I certainly wouldn't be able to get involved with that. But whatever I am asked to do, I'll get back to what I said. 3 groups that I will not say no to, and the village is number 1 on that list. That's it.
Thank you. All right, who was number 4?
I'm number 4.
All right, Mark, when you're ready, read your question aloud.
Okay. Reminderville has come a long way with a lot of progress and growth. What ideas do you have to keep us going in a positive direction? Well, I've already spoken of how I think it's so important to reach financial stability with the RAC. We have such an excellent fire and police department. We need to keep the RAC a steady part of the budget so that we don't affect the levels of safety forces that we enjoy. I'm going to help the campaign to push for to pass the road levy that's going to come up next year. We put a lot of work into our roads. I mean, between when I moved here 8 years ago and the way they look today, the roads are incredible. And we're going to need that road levy to pass to make sure they're incredible for another 10, 20 years. I like to see more senior programs. I used to be liaison to the seniors group, but when the RAC was built, that broke up. And one of the last things I talked to Colleen about was bringing more senior activities to the RAC center, maybe bringing back a bi-monthly meeting, but to get more involved with seniors and more senior activities. I know Becky's talked about developing more transportation for seniors. I think that's a great idea. And finally, what I'd like to do is bring back the Parks and Rec. At that Halloween party the other day, we built such a reputation for a fabulous Halloween party. We ran out of candy Saturday. And I don't blame Aaron because what does he know about the Halloween party? We've been doing it for so long. If we have that Parks and Rec committee back to assist whoever becomes program director, or if Aaron's thrust into that position again, with our help, you know, it takes 10 years to build a great reputation for that party. It takes one to ruin it. And I don't want the RAC to get a bad reputation about anything.
Thank you, Mark. All right, Tom, that leaves you.
It's me. Beyond the regular ongoing business of the village, what big challenges do you see for us, and how will you address this? Well, anybody who knows me, I'm a money person. Money is always ongoing business, but we have the municipal center, the RAC, police department, fire department's part of the municipal center. I believe we need to start saving for the upkeep of these buildings. So in 10 years when we need a major renovation on any of them, or even 5 years, we have the money to pay for it and not to take out a bond or to take out a loan. All those do is cost you money and interest, and that's money we can use to spend on something else. We started several years ago saving money for vehicles. Mark was a big champion of that. $30,000 a year, sometimes it's more, that we save so we can, when the time comes up, we can pay for those vehicles without having to do them on loan or what, you know, on a loan. So I want to expand it, like I said, to the buildings. So, and even more for the vehicles. That way, if something comes up, hey, we have the money. Also like to create, and I know the mayor's talked about this as well, a rainy day fund for anything that might come up. Put in $50,000 a year in this fund and just let it build up. Hopefully it's more than that, but we need to start saving. I am not a person who likes to lease. I don't like loans in my personal life, and I try to do it here as well. So I know we paid for the police cars we don't do on loan, the rescue squad we paid for in cash, service department, some of them we paid in cash, so we just need to keep doing that and save money on interest.
Thank you, Tom. All right, lastly, what we'll do is each candidate will have to give their closing statements. And again, when we started the candidates, they drew straws initially, so we're going to work in the order that each candidate drew their straw. So we'll start with Mark Condick. Mark, go ahead.
Well, win or lose, I want to thank the community of Reminderville for letting me serve for 8 years. I love this village, and I really enjoy being involved in shaping the future. Oh, Lee's not here, but I want to thank Lee Bartholman, who introduced me to the Vision 2020 group, which got me started being active in the community. I want to thank him again for coming over and pestering me while I was mowing the lawn to run for the Charter Commission, because it was from there that I moved on to be elected to council. I'd like to thank my wife, Noreen, for putting up with me on Tuesday nights when I came home in a crabby mood when things didn't go well. And I'd like to thank everybody in this room, because this is the kind of participation that the community needs. I have the utmost respect for my opponents, and I have no doubt, no matter who you elect, we're going to have a great council. And I want to thank you for your time and respectfully ask for your vote.
Thank you, Mark. All right, next we'll go with Becky Kolbach.
Thank you. Thank you all again for coming out tonight. I have worked in the public sector for more than 12 years. I've done this job, I'm the Stacy in North Olmsted. I've done this job day in and day out. I have a passion for public service. Right when I moved here, I mean, I got involved. I joined the committees and things like that. I really love it, and I hope that I get elected in, 6 days. I'm uniquely positioned to serve as an advocate for the village, and I know Mark had talked about the seniors and some of my passions, and I just want to help continue to make Reminderville a great place to call home and raise a family. So, thank you, guys.
All right, thank you, Becky. Next, we'll go with Mr. Walt Hoffman.
First of all, I'd like to thank appreciate the fact that for the last 4 years I've had a chance to serve on council, and I certainly want to continue doing that. There's some obvious things that I'd like to talk about in regards to the community and making sure infrastructure remains at a forefront of what we're doing. Concerned about the drainage problems that we're having, and hopefully this is going to get fixed over the next year with the work that we're doing. And I have another issue that probably doesn't get much play, but it's one that I'm very concerned about. Reminderville can easily become 5 or 6 or 7 different housing developments where people say, oh, I live in the historic part of the city, or I live in Willowbrook, or I live in Aurora Shores. And I think in some way that would be a shame for Reminderville. I think what we really want is for everyone to say, with a lot of pride, I live in Reminderville. It is really a great place to raise a family, and it's a great place to live. And so, if I'm elected, I'm going to really, I think, try to hit on that theme, and that we all, and the notion that there be pride in this community of Reminderville. We have a unique place, it's a wonderful place to raise a family, and let's keep it that way, and I'll be committed to that. Thank you.
Thank you, Walt. Next, we'll go with Tom.
Well, thank you, everybody who decided to come. Since moving here in 77 when I was 6, as I mentioned before, going to school with Watt and Laura's daughter in elementary school and grade school, and in 4 different houses in the village, riding my bike, just playing in the street. I mean, I've been here almost all my life. Not consecutively. I had some other places I lived, but I really know the village. I really care about the village. People who watch our video, our council meetings and video, or just know me from around town, know I tell it like it is. Sometimes I'm more blunt than I should be, but you know where I stand. I don't mince words. Sometimes I'm not very politically correct either, but again, sometimes that's what's needed. Just be straightforward, and that is definitely me, and I will definitely keep doing that. I'm also the word Walt used was committed. The 8 years of all the committees and council, I've only missed one meeting in that whole time span, and that was because I had to get ready for a colonoscopy, yay. But I even made the meetings before that council meeting that I missed, so I was still here even that day. So
we're getting ready for a colonoscopy. I'm glad you
missed it. Yeah, right. That would have been a mess. But anyway, we might be having another one on Tuesday too, so all of us. So anyway, I hope you vote for me. Like I said, I'm straightforward, as you just heard. I'd like to be your councilman for another 4 years, so thank you.
Thank you, Tom.
I'm gonna ask permission to do something, and I would ask the chair to allow us to do it. I feel bad for Vicki, because I understand completely why she's not here. And could I just say a few words in her behalf?
I don't have a problem with it. As long as the other cameras don't. So.
Is that her pulling in? It comes a white van.
Oh, is it pulling in? Is she pulling in?
Okay,
let's just
stall
for a minute and let her do her own task.
We can dance.
Yeah.
Same?
Are you up? No. I appreciate all the service you guys are doing.
Yeah.
All the things, all the committees, all the meetings.
Thank you.
It's great.
You're fun. You really are.
Yeah. It's a lot of work, but it's
fun.
It's fun.
want to say?
I'm open for questions if you need. I mean, it's not election day, but I'm always here if anybody wants to.
And if anybody's
thank
not
you, I want to thank you all for coming out and doing this, and I want to thank everybody here. I wish it would have been a little more populous. I mean, that's just something that we need to know. We've made a lot of strides in 18 years as the mayor, so.
What we did was, I'm sure you probably were aware, everyone read a question, we randomly picked it from a bag. This was the one that was left for you, so
okay.
You can read this aloud. You can also, finish reading your question and give a closing statement if you'd like. And
okay. All right, thank you. And thanks again. I'm sorry I'm late. My daughter was being honored as Student of the Month at Twinsburg, so thanks for understanding. I really appreciate it. I'm Vicki Jerome Miss Blaney, by the way. Let's see. What's my question? There's a chance that we could end up with 5 of 6 council people from Aurora Shores. In hindsight, do you agree with the decision to remove wards from our charter? Good question. I mean, absolutely. I think it was a good idea to remove the wards, just to make sure that we always have enough opportunity to get more people for the people of the village to be able to see and vote on. Just like in this case. I mean, thankfully there's 5 of us going up for 4 positions. So it really gives everybody in the village a chance and an opportunity to have 5 very different people and see what per people that you want on council that would work for you in the long run. So, and then closing statement?
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you. Well, thank you so much. I am a 13-year resident of the village of Reminderville. Absolutely love it here. My husband and I have been married 19 years. We have 3 kids. My oldest in high school. Can't believe that he's getting ready for college, and we've been doing college visits. My middle one's 13, loves bowling, and is fun and hilarious. And cures the student of the month, so it's awesome. But right now, I am also a photographer. I work as with my... am I running out of time? Yeah. Oh, okay. Sorry. But anyways, I would love your vote. I have, if you want to find out anything about me, please go to VickiForCouncil.com. I have many different experiences, not only be a mother, a business owner, a photographer. I'm also, I have a bachelor's degree from Kent State. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Vicki.
Thank you.
All right. Well, I think we should probably thank Mayor Alonzo. Thank you, Mayor, for providing this for the candidates.
Thank you guys for all showing up, and thank you for, now that you don't see too often where other candidates say, yeah, we'll wait.
Yeah.
Right.
Thank you.
I know it wouldn't happen in the presidential election. Right? We don't know that. But thank you for everything. Thank you for coming out, everyone. Mm-hmm. Appreciate
that's why we're
it.
A great place to call.
Thanks again.
Thank you. Thank you guys
for
attending.
Thank you.